Hello. Welcome to How to Turn TP-Link Router into a VPN Server with WireGuard. You only need a router to access resources in your local network remotely. This is a high-speed, free and secure VPN solution. Let's get started. I use a computer connected to the router and the local network. On the computer you use any browser to log into the device management page. If you cannot access using the IP address, then you use the local domain name. On the management page you go to Advanced Settings. Then you go to Configure the VPN Server. The device supports many VPN solutions. In this case I used WireGuard. A secure, high speed and easy to configure solution. You enable the VPN server. I use the default parameters. I do not change the port, IP address range. I allow clients to access remotely via the VPN this. Next you create the configuration files for the clients. You can create multiple configuration files for different clients. You just enter the client name, the other parameters are automatically generated by the router. The client needs the configuration file to connect to the server, so you export it. You can use a computer or a phone to connect remotely using this VPN solution. In this case, I use a computer as a client to test the results. On the computer, I install the application. After completing the installation of the client application, you add the configuration file created in the previous step. The VPN is quickly set up in the local network. This is the first step to create a remote connection. You can see the connection status of the clients on the device management page. Next, I will guide you how to set up a remote connection using a public IP address. My router does not directly connect to the internet, it is behind the main router. So I forward the port on the main router to it. To do so, I set up a static IP address for this device. You cannot forward ports to an IP address that can be changed. I log into the main router's management page. On the main router, I forward the port to the VPN server. I forward the default port of the VPN service. After completing the port forwarding, you can connect remotely. You edit the client's configuration file. Instead of using the local IP address, I use the public IP address. The connection has been established, so you can access remotely. But the connection will be interrupted if the public IP address changes. You can fix that problem by using a dynamic domain name. You just need to register a free account of the router. This router supports you to create a free dynamic domain name. After successfully logging in, you create a new domain name. This domain name helps you update the public IP address. You just need to connect to the VPN using this dynamic domain name. I will try set up a VPN using a domain name instead of a public IP address. I connect to a different network to make sure the two devices are not on the same local network. Connection successful with dynamic domain name. Although my computer is connected to a different network, it can still set up a VPN successfully. So I have completed turning my TP-Link router into a VPN server. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I will go to the device management page, access the shared folder or use the diagnostic tool to test the VPN connection. Good luck.